a CBC color presentation.
From Vancouver, British Columbia, it's the Irish Rovers.
A long time ago, when the earth was green,
there was more kinds of animals than you've ever seen.
They'd run around free while the earth was being born.
And the loveliest of them all
was the hush puppy.
Hello there, this is Santa Claus. And I'm here to tell you you're going to be watching the Irish Rovers Christmas special with guests Shari Lewis and Lamb Chop.
Without me, I'm Hush Puppy, and I'd like to give you a little Christmas spirit. Ho, 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 and a sock in your fireplace. Pow!
Lovely little thing.
There was green
alligators upon their geese, some monkey black camels and some chimpanzees, some cats and mice in the
Santa Claus said, it's the Irish Rovers Christmas party tonight, and we have a great bunch of merrymakers with us. Will you join us in a wee song about Christmas in Ireland? Christmas in Killarney. Play away.
The holly green, the ivy green, the prettiest picture you've ever seen. It's Christmas in Killarney, but none of the folks at home. It's nice, you know, to kiss your beau and cuddle it under the mistletoe. It's Santa Claus, you all would know, is one of the boys from home. The door is always open, the neighbors pay a call, and Father John before he's gone will bless the house at all. I've run the fields to quick your heels and join in the fun of the Dixon. I'm handing you no Killarney, the likes you've never known. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks that woo! The holly green, the ivy green, the prettiest picture you've ever seen. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks at home. Hey! Woo!
This is an old goatskin tambourine, and we boys in Ireland 100 years ago used to go around with goatskin tambourines called bellerons, and they used to get a little bird called a wren on Christmas Day and hit it on the head and put it in a holly tree with ribbons and collect money for the wren's funeral. How do you like that? On the day after Christmas, they called it St. Stephen's Day. Here's a song called the Wren Boys Song, an old, old Christmas song from Ireland, and you can sing the chorus too. Play on.
They're in, the king of all birds, St. Stephen's Day was cutting the first, knocking the knocker and ringing the bell, give us a penny for singing so well. Woo! I have a wee box under me arm, a couple of pennies will do it no harm, up with a kettle in there with a pot, and give us a penny for singing so well. They're in, the king of all birds, St. Stephen's Day was cutting the first, knocking the knocker and ringing the bell, and give us a penny for singing so well. Christmas Day, I turn the spit, I burn me finger, I feel it yet. Between me finger and me thumb, there lies a blister as big as a plum. They're in, the king of all birds, St. Stephen's Day was cutting the birds, knocking the knocker and ringing the bell, and give us a penny for singing so well.
I followed the wren 3 miles or more, miles or more, 3 miles or more. I followed the wren 3 miles or more, and Christmas Day in the morning.
They're in, the king of all birds, St. Stephen's Day was cutting the first, knocking the knocker and ringing the bell. Give us a penny for singing so well.
But don't you be doing that now. Hey, all the kids were saying, well, you don't look like you're dressed up for a Christmas party. Well, you know something? What about all the wee boys and girls that live down in Trinidad and the West Indies and all those sunny islands? They don't have any snow for Santa Claus or anything, but they still have Christmas and they still sing Christmas carols. And this is a Christmas carol from Trinidad in the West Indies. And if you know the chorus, you can sing too, called Mary's Boy Child.
Well, a long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible say, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, new king born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. wise shepherds watch their flocks by night, them see a bright new shining star, and then they hear a choir sing, the music seem to come from afar.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, you came born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Joseph and his wife Mary came to Bethlehem that night, but they find no place for the born a child, not a single room was in sight. By and by they find a little nook in a stable all forlorn, and in a manger cold and dark Mary's little boy child was born.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, you came born today.
I love it.
And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
One more time.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, listen what I say, that man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Okay. Yeah, you're lovely singers. There's a lovely, lovely lady who is our guest on our show now and again, and we're very, very happy every time she is. She's our special Christmas guest, or our special Christmas gift, I should say, to all the boys and girls tonight. And she has friends like Hush Puppy and Lamb Chop, and she's none other than the beautiful Shari Lewis.
You gonna do a Christmas carol?
No, honey, I'm gonna yo-yo. Stand back, please. Out on the mountain so happy and free. Oh, that is a flat note. There lived a maid waiting for me. Oh, that's even flatter. Out on the lake drift with the tide. And it bells are ringing, ay-yo-le, roosters are singing. Ha, 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 you know that's hard for a dog. Ay-yo-le. Oh, you really know how to hurt a dog. A yodeling. Get the lady. Get the lady. Go.
Shari Lewis.
Listen while I tell you. What's that? Tales to warm your mind. Listen, see what you can.
A message from Robin? You never know what's going to happen around this forest next. Help! I'm in a cave held captive by a fierce dragon, signed Princess Lamb Chops. There's only one jolly bunch of lads I know can help me get this princess out of this fix. The Forest Brigade Service. I'll give them a call.
Have no fear, the bun is here.
Hi, Willie.
You two are the Forest Brigade Service?
Who'd you expect, Batman and Robin?
Listen, I suppose you'll have to do. There's nothing else I can use. It says here in this message I just received, help me in the cave. Held captive. A beautiful princess held captive in the cave.
Well, we'll rescue her. That's what we're here for, sure.
Yeah! She's held captive by a fierce dragon.
The union says forest fires.
Broken mushrooms.
And off-duty lifeguard at the forest swamp.
And besides, the swords are broken. So goodbye, Tootsie. Goodbye.
You cowards, there's gold in the cave.
What?
But there's gold.
Gold?
I love gold.
A hoard of gold.
A hoard of gold.
Will you help me?
Of course we'll help you. Okay. We get the gold, you get the princess.
Onward to the cave.
Here.
Wonderful. I didn't have enough trouble with the dragon. Oh, I really needed you.
Help! 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 You're going to get the dragon all excited again.
Oh, down on your knees, knave.
Who are you to call me a knave?
You are just a lowly leprechaun. Well, I am a princess of the royal blood.
Would you like to see me bleed a little?
How come the dragon captures somebody like you?
Because, dummy, dragons always capture us beautiful princesses.
Hey, do the dragons eat princesses?
No, they eat leprechauns. Broil them on their tongue.
Oh, very, very funny.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Well, anyway, we're here to rescue you.
Yeah? Well, thanks a lot. I'll stick with the dragon.
Yeah, well, actually, we're actually here for the gold.
Get your twerple.
Ouch.
My gold.
Hey, you little thing.
Are you a leprechaun, too?
Yeah, do you like me?
Well,
do you?
Hey, listen. How come there's so many of you leprechaunies here in this here cave? Is this where leprechaunies usually live?
Well, no. Actually, we're usually under little mushrooms.
Oh, do you know what?
What?
Last week, I think I ate a leprechaun.
What?
Yes, it was under a mushroom.
What did this little guy look like?
A steak.
Oh, gold! Gold!
Get your gold off my twerp.
Here, Princess.
Where?
Lamb Chop, your highness.
Oh!
How are you?
Oh, look! Oh, that form! Oh, that face! Oh, I know you are not a leprechaun. You are a knight. Good day, good night.
Princess Lamb Chop.
Yes,
I think
yes.
We're wasting so much time in this cave fooling around here.
Yes.
We're here on
a
mission to rescue you.
We've come to rescue you. Yes.
Don't pay any
attention. Listen. If you rescue me, my father, the king, will give you the hand of his firstborn in marriage.
The hand of his firstborn in marriage?
Yes.
And I wonder who might the firstborn be.
Me. Come and get it. He might even give you the rest of her.
Listen, this is no time for flippancy.
I'm not being flippancy.
The yonder dragon will eat all of us up in one swift bite if we don't hurry up and get out of here. Now, I happen to know that there's...
Yes. I'm acting.
There's probably only one way that we could all get out of here very safely, and that's by a magic word.
Oh, yes.
And I happen to know...
Yes?
Shh. that Bun Worrier has a big magic word.
Mm-hmm. He should, because he sure got a big mouth.
Can someone call me?
Yeah. Bun, the very man we're waiting on. Say the magic word and get us out of this predicament. Yeah, hurry up.
Have no fear before your very eyes. I'll reduce this dragon down to size.
A wrap for the bunny!
Ah, get out of here.
Just say the word, Bun.
Bally slap a guttery.
Help! Help! Help!
Didn't work too well that time, Bun.
Well, what can you expect from this coyote?
There's only one answer to solve this terrible predicament that we're in.
What is it?
That's if we all say the magic word together.
That could work.
You can't do it.
No, because you see, I don't understand what those silly words mean. And those could be X-rated words, as far as I'm concerned, and I am a G princess.
A G princess.
In fact, I'm like 2G.
And what's a 2G?
A goody-goody.
If you carry on this way any longer, we'll all get eaten up.
Now, don't yell at the lady.
I'll tell you what we'll do.
Yes, yes.
If we all say the word, I don't mean just us, I mean all the children as well that are watching. If we all say it together, we'll get out of here.
Okay.
Right?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, go.
Well, you did it. You cut the dragon down to size. Thank you. I am now going to ride off, and you may keep all of the gold for your very own. Hi-ho, Greeny.
Ow, look at all the wonderful, wonderful money. Let's Bun. That's mine.
Not only did the dragon dwindle, but the money dwindled, too.
Well, how much did we get? How much did we get?
55 cents.
Oh!
Bally slap McGuttrick.
On a snow-covered mountain there's a little Christmas tree, and all the big trees call him Pee-wee. They call him Miss, 'cause he's so small. He's 9 years old and only 2 feet tall. Poor little Pee-wee Christmas tree, how sad and lonely you must be. When people come to get their tree, they take all the others, but they never take Pee-wee. From your place on the mountain, you watch the town below. The trees people take are all aglow. They stand in the windows lit up so bright, waiting for Santa to come on Christmas night. Christmas tree, how sad and lonely you must be. When people come to get their tree, they take all the others, but they never take Pee-wee. A star from the sky sprinkled stardust on Pee-wee. People in the town looked up to see. They couldn't believe just what they saw. He sparkles so bright, the brightest tree of them all.
Look how he sparkles.
Poor little Pee-wee Christmas tree, how gay and happy you must be. Now when people come to get their tree, they will want you for their own. Little Pee-wee Christmas.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
He's not so dwarfy now, is he?
Hey, Pee-wee, you're beautiful. Still a little weird, but he's okay with me, boy.
Yeah, he's sure okay with me.
Hey, let's have a wild party at McCarthy's house. Come on.
If you're lonely, look at me. I know the man to see. The other night I met McCarthy staggering down the way. Convened and say, won't you come and join our party? Our house to be sure, be crowded to the door. Everyone will be gay and hearty. The Murphys and the Bradys be there with their shillings.
Where?
Down at McCarthy's party. At McCarthy's party.
what would a Christmas party be without the great old favourite Christmas songs? The ones that you all know and sing every year for 100 years.
Will you
join us in them all?
Yeah.
The rest of you too. Come on, play away.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose.
Oh, oh.
And if you ever saw him, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeers used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright,
Jingle bells,
dashing through the snow, and the one horse.